13th March 1940. Kexton Hall, London. Sir Michael O'Dwyer assassinated. An Indian fired 6 rounds. Lord Zetland, Secretary for India, Sir Louis Dane, and Lord Lymington injured. Nobody knew who the assassin was. The assassin put up no resistance and let the police take him into their custody. He gave his name, Ram Mohammed Singh Azad, in the FIR. On probing into his papers, however, the police found out his real name, Udham Singh. He had achieved his life's mission by shooting O'Dwyer, the villain of the piece, in the sordid tragedy of Jallianwala Bagh in 1919. On June 5, Udham Singh was sentenced to death. This day, 50 years ago, July 31, 1940, this quiet Indian walked up calmly to the gallows at London's Pentonville Jail. Not many Indians knew at that time who this patriot was. Where did he come from, and what were his political affiliations or objectives? Admiring countrymen searched for details. Sunam, a small town in the princely state of Patiala in East Punjab. This was the town where Udham Singh was born, the second son of Tehel Singh. This was about the year 1900. Udham Singh was not fortunate enough to have a normal childhood. He had lost both his mother and father by the time he was about 7 years of age. Apparently, he had no near relative, none who would be kind enough to look after the two children. In Amritsar, an orphanage had been set up by Chief Khalsa Diwan in 1904. Some kindly person got the two children admitted in that home for orphans in 1907. Udham Singh grew up here, in the only home he had known throughout life, a home run on charity. Besides attending a school, the children learned Gurbani, teachings of the Sikh gurus, devotional music, and some crafts. Amritsar got its name from Amrit Sarovar, the pool of nectar, the sacred pool in which stands the holy Harmandir, the golden temple. This city was also a flourishing center of trade. It was known mainly as the most sacred place, place of pilgrimage for the Sikhs. But the year 1919 altered the situation. Amritsar came to be known also as the city of the Jallianwala Bagh, a byword for monstrous bloodshed and humiliation of Indians, a monument of British barbarism. Udham Singh was the child of this Amritsar. To know Udham Singh, we need to know what he saw and lived through. Agitation against the Black Law, Rowlatt Act of 1919, and the mob fury after police firing on a protesting procession in Amritsar had frightened the civil administration. On 11th April 1919, the city of Amritsar was handed over to the army under the command of Brigadier General Dyer. Gatherings and processions were prohibited. 13th April 1919, Sunday, was the day of Baisakhi festival. Thousands came to Amritsar from villages as usual to bathe in the sacred Sarovar and worship at the Golden Temple. Ignorant of the prohibition orders, many walked into Jallianwala Bagh near the Golden Temple. The Bagh was surrounded on all sides by houses and high walls. A meeting was being addressed by political agitators in a corner. Hearing that several thousand people had gathered in the Bagh in spite of his orders, Dyer marched 50 of his soldiers into the Bagh. The entrance lane was narrow. Deploying the troops on a high ground on the right and the left of the entrance, he ordered, "Fire!" directing personally from time to time his soldiers to fire where the crowd was thickest. People ran, groped, faltered, stood up, and fell dead along the walls they tried to scale for safety. General Dyer withdrew only when the ammunition ran short, leaving around 1,500 dead and many, many injured. Udham Singh is believed to have been a dazed eyewitness to the barbarity and the humiliation of Indians. He was submerged in shame and surcharged with indignation. Shame and indignation were a reflection of a widespread reaction throughout the country. The time has come when badges of honor make our shame glaring in their incongruous context of humiliation. With these words echoed the voice of Rabindranath Tagore, who relinquished his knighthood. Sir Winston Churchill called it a monstrous event, an event which stands in singular and sinister isolation. But the British House of Lords collected a special fund to honor General Dyer for what they called saving India for the crown. Udham Singh could not forget these events even for a moment. Authentic evidence available on his life and activities hereafter is rather meager, but a few facts stand out as available from the people who knew him.
ਸਨ 1928-29 ਚ 30 ਤੱਕ ਸ਼ਹੀਦ ਉਧਮ ਸਿੰਘ ਇੱਥੇ ਆਉਂਦੇ ਰਹੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੋ ਸਾਲਾਂ ਚ ਇੱਥੇ ਆ ਕੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਇਸੇ ਮਕਾਨ ਚ ਆ ਕੇ ਠਹਿਰਦੇ ਤੇ ਇਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਦਾ ਮਕਾਨ ਮੇਰਾ ਹੈ ਮੈਂ ਉਦੋਂ ਪੜ੍ਹਦਾ ਸਾਂ 9ਵੀਂ 10ਵੀਂ ਜਮਾਤ ਚ ਉਹ ਮੈਂ ਵੀ ਹੁਣ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਪੜ੍ਹਦਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਤਾਂ ਬੈਠ ਕੇ ਭਾਈ ਹੁਸ਼ਿਆਰ ਸਿੰਘ ਦਾ ਇਹ ਮਕਾਨ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਇਕੱਲੇ ਹੀ ਥੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਆ ਕੇ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਇਕੱਲਿਆਂ ਪਾਸੇ ਠਹਿਰਦਾ
ਵਾਈਲ ਵਿਜ਼ਿਟਿੰਗ ਹਿਸ ਹੋਮ ਟਾਊਨ ਸੁਨਾਮ ਹੀ ਵੁੱਡ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਸਟੇ ਇਨ ਅ ਲੋਨਲੀ ਹਾਊਸ ਐਂਡ ਵੁੱਡ ਪਲੇ ਅਗੇਨ ਐਂਡ ਅਗੇਨ ਦ ਡਿਸਕ ਆਫ ਬੰਦੇ ਮਾਤਰਮ ਔਨ ਹਿਸ ਗ੍ਰੈਮੋਫੋਨ ਇੱਕ
ਦਿਨ ਉਹ ਆਪਣੇ ਇੱਕ ਫੋਟੋ ਲੈ ਤਸਵੀਰ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਏ ਅਖਬਾਰ ਚੋਂ ਕੱਟੀ ਹੋਈ
ਵੈਨੇਵਰ ਹੀ ਸਟੰਬਲਡ ਔਨ ਅ ਸਟੋਨ ਔਰ ਸਮਥਿੰਗ He would curse the British rule and not the stone or something. In 1931, Udham Singh stayed in Kashmir, disguised in saffron. There he stayed with one Swaran Singh Versola, a member of a revolutionary party, for about 25 days. Swaran Singh recalled
पार्टी वालों मेरी ड्यूटी लगी कश्मीर जान दी, मेरे नाल दो बंदे होर गए सन। उत्थे कुछ दिन रहने के बाद वह अपने प्रोग्राम के पार्टी प्रोग्राम के मुताबिक पंजाब आ गए, मैं उत्थे कल्ला रहा। एक दिन मैं हाकी ग्राउंड से बैठा, तौलिया बिछा के लागे एक गोरा बैठक और किताब इंग्लिश का नावल से जरा मैं खालसा कॉलेज लाइब्रेरी तो लिया सी, वो लैके बैठा हुआ सा। तो एक हाकी की गेम चल रही थी, मैं इंजॉय कर रहा सा। एक महापुरुष बड़ी चंगी पर्सनैलिटी वाला भगवे कपड़े पाए हुए।
ऑन बीइंग क्वेश्चन्ड बाय अ सस्पिशियस स्वरण सिंह इफ ही वाज रियली अ भक्ता क्लैड एज ही वाज इन सैफ्रन, he replied, oh yes, I am a bhakta of Shaheed Bhagat Singh, and whipped out of his pocket a photograph of the great martyr. He said, I am yet in a state of mental determination. When this determination gets translated on the actional plane, you will see whether I have succeeded in the mission of my bhakti or not.
कि मैं अपनी भक्ति से कामयाब हो गया कि नहीं हो गया।
पांच साल की उम्र बिच थी मैं उदो जो कॉलेज तो छुट्टी आंदे हुंदे सी, आके इतने सारे काम करने, मैनू कपड़े धोने तो मैं इनू कहना भी प्रेस लिया के दे, वो लिया के मैं दे कपड़े प्रेस कराने उन्होंने मेरे तो ते रोटी
पकवाने। One of his visits to Sunam, he met a lady who recalled her own mother's encounter with Udham Singh thus. On being asked by the old lady's mother if he did not contemplate marrying, he said, no, I shall not marry. I am wedded to another mission. When that mission is fulfilled, you will know it yourself. I have to go abroad. I must go abroad. Equipped with the kit of skills like handcrafts, especially carpentry and driving of all sorts of vehicles, he managed to go to San Francisco in US. Where he got actively involved in the activities of the revolutionary Ghadar Party started by Lala Hardayal. Another country he visited in the mid-30s was England, where he worked as a motor mechanic, in which job he was very proficient. Udham Singh had a refreshing sense of humor, which kept him relaxed in the midst of sordid realities. For instance, soon after his arrest following the murder of Odwaya, he wrote to Shiv Singh Johal from Brixton Jail, I am the guest of His Majesty King George now. In his letters, he asked a friend to send him Waris Shah's epic, Heer. In the court, during his trial, he refused to take an oath on the Bible or any other religious book. he would rather take an oath on Heer Waris, asserted Udham Singh. In the court, he was not at all interested in defending himself. I don't care. I don't mind dying. I am dying for my country. I don't mind what is the sentence, 10, 20 or 50 years, or to be hanged. I have done my duty. On the day of his tryst with the gallows, he was asked, what was his last wish? That my country becomes independent soon, and my ashes be sent to my country, replied Udham Singh. His ashes were brought to India, to his native place Sunam, on July 31, 1974. Shaheed Udham Singh, or Ram Mohammad Singh Azad, as he preferred to be known, is remembered by his countrymen for his unflinching and unswerving patriotism. However, the fittest tribute to Ram Mohammad Singh Azad, Udham Singh that is, would be a complete harmony between all communities of India who were welded together as if in Ram Mohammad Singh Azad. His assumed name was eloquently symbolic of the unity of all Indians, free from any taint of community, creed or caste. Such Indians alone, according to Udham Singh, could achieve true freedom for India.